So unconventional machining process. First, we want to study what is conventional machining process. So conventional machining process is nothing but removing a metal using direct contact between tool and the workpiece. So direct contact between the tool and the workpiece. Second one, no will be a wear in the tool when the workpiece is harder. So this process is called a traditional process or conventional process. In this case, what type of machines or what type of operations? Drilling, reaming, boring. This kind of operations done by conventional machining process. Main thing, direct contact between tool and the workpiece. Direct contact means the tool touch the workpiece and remove the metal. So this is the direct contact. Tool touch the workpiece and remove the metal. So this process is also called traditional machining process. Second one, what is unconventional machining process? So unconventional machining process means no physical contact between the tool and the workpiece during the machining process. In the machining process time, metal will be removing. That time, the tool and the workpiece are not within a physical contact. It will not touch. Some gap will be there. So this type of process is unconventional machining process. At the same time, machining will done some form of energy for material removal. No contact with tool and workpiece. At the same time, some energy will be created between the tool and the workpiece. There will be no wear and tear of the tool piece. So this process is called unconventional machining process or non-traditional machining process. So for our subject, we want to study unconventional machining process. Why we using unconventional machining process? Or why need of unconventional machining process? Metal which has high strength, high temperature resistant are difficult to machining in conventional machining process. So we using unconventional machining process method, and many application need high yield strength, temperature resistant alloy in the field like aerospace, nuclear engineering, etc. This metal cannot be easily machined during conventional machining process. So for example, in the conventional machining process, some metals we cannot easily remove the metals. For this case, we using unconventional. The machine finish will be not perfect in conventional machining process. So we can choose unconventional machining process. So this kind of errors we using unconventional machining process. Classification. For this classification, we can divide it into four based on energy, based on mechanism, source of energy, medium of transfer. So for shape of material, or based on this shape of material, we choose electrical, electrochemical, chemical, mechanical and thermal methods. These are the unconventional machining methods based on this shape of material, based different type of materials. We can choose different type of methods: electrical energy methods, electrochemical energy methods, chemical energy methods, mechanical energy methods, thermal energy methods. Here we have energy, type of energy required to shape of material. So the second one, what are the mechanism involved in this process? Erosion, isonic dissolution and vaporization. These are the mechanism involved. Third one, material removal. Source of energy required for material removal. That one is hydrostatic pressure, high current density, high voltage, isonized material. This four for all involved in material removal. Then medium of transverse of energies. So high voltage particles, electrolyte, electron and hot gases. We all involved some energies for different type of machines. Some machines we use high voltage particles. Sometimes some machining process we use electrolyte. Some machining process we use electrons. And some machining process we use hot gases. So this one is called energy transverse. Because there we have a gap between tool and the workpiece. So in this gap we use high voltage particles, electrolyte, electrons and hot gases. So these are the elaborated flow chart for non-conventional machining process or unconventional machining process. So here this side, energy type, basic mechanism, source of intimate energy, transfer energy medium, processes. These are all process. What are the process involved in unconventional machining process? So first one, energy type. So energy type already discussed in the previous slide. So the first one is mechanical, second one is electrochemical, and the third one is chemical, and the fourth one is thermoelectrical. So electrical and thermal involved. Mechanism. For mechanical, so this one is basic mechanism involved in unconventional machining process. For this basic mechanism, for mechanical methods, mechanism shear or erosion. For electrochemical, long displacement, chemical ablative action, thermal and electrical vaporization and fusion. And the third one is source of intermediate energy. For mechanical, cutting tool, pneumatic or hydraulic pressure. For electrochemical, high current. And chemical reactive agent. For thermoelectric, for vaporization based on this, high voltage or amplified lights. For fusion, we used ionized material. Transfer, so this one is physical contact. What type of process we done here means mechanical contour grinding. For erosion techniques, high voltage particles and high voltage liquid we using for transfer energy. Two type of processes for high velocity particles, that one is abrasive jet machining and ultrasonic machining. We use high velocity particles. Based on this only we use this one for this two type of process. And we remove the metal because we have some gap between tool and the workpiece. So the second one, high velocity liquid, that one is jet machining or whirling jet machine, water jet machining or jet machining. Another one, electrochemical. For electrochemical, we use electrolyte. For this electrolyte, what type of process we using means electrochemical grinding and electrochemical machining. So these are the process we involved by using this electrolyte. And chemical machining, so chemical etching, chemical machining, hot chlorine machining. So these are on based on this environment. For the final one, thermoelectrical type machining process, what are the process involved means electrical discharge machining and electron beam machining. For this electrical discharge machining and electron beam machining, we use electrons. That medium of energy transfer, we using electrons. This electrons only involved in this process and remove the metals. And the second one, radiation. So that transfer energy medium is radiation. This radiation we using the machining method is laser beam machining. For this laser beam machining, we involved this radiation. And the final one is hot gases. We are using hot gases for this two process, machining process, that's ion beam machining and plasma arc machining. So both this two machining process, we are using hot gases for removing the metal. So far already we discussed in the third or fourth slide mechanical energy methods. So based on the energy shape of material, there we have five methods: the mechanical, thermal, then electrical energy methods, electrochemical energy methods and chemical energy methods. So the first one is mechanical energy methods. For this mechanical energy methods, there we have three type of machining methods, machines. First one is abrasive jet machining, and the second one is water jet machining, and the third one is ultrasonic machining. So these three methods are involved in mechanical energy methods. And the second one is electrical energy methods. So this electrical energy methods, here we have two type of machining process. The first one is electro discharge machining. Simplify, we tell EDM, electro discharge machining, and wire cut electrical discharge machining. This two of them involved in this electrical energy methods. And the third one is electrochemical energy methods. So for this electrochemical energy methods, these are the machines. That one is electrochemical machining in the simple form of ECM. And the second one is electrochemical grinding. That one is electrochemical grinding, means ECG. Third one is ECH. That means electrochemical honing. And the fourth one is electrochemical deburring. These are the four machinings involved in this electrochemical energy methods. The fourth one is chemical energy method. Here we using only chemical energy, chemical machine for machining process. We using chemicals. The final one is thermal energy methods. In thermal energy methods, we have four machinings. That one is laser beam machining, plasma arc machining, third one is electron beam machining, and fourth one is ion beam machining. So these are the four methods used in thermal energy methods. So next one is process selection parameters. These are the parameters involved in this machining process. How can we select? First one is physical method process. Second one is shape to be machined. Third one is machine characteristics. Fourth one is economic consideration. So these are the physical parameters. For example, if we use non-metal like ceramic, plastic and glass. If we use non-metallic, that means ceramics, plastic and glass, we use ultrasonic machining, abrasive jet machining, EBM, electron beam machining and laser beam machining. By using this machining, we remove the metal easily. For example, superalloys means we use abrasive jet machining, electrochemical machining, electrical discharge machining, plasma arc machining. So these are the machinings for superalloys. Based on this machine only, we can remove the metals. So these are the physical parameters. So the physical parameters means each and every machines, there we have some parameters. Parameters means current, voltage, power, gap, medium. What is this gap means? In unconventional machining, no physical contact between tool and the workpiece. So we need some gaps. We put some gap between tool and the workpiece. So for this case, which dimensions, which measurements we need to give for this gap, for each and every machining? These are the parameters. Potential, that means voltage, current. Power, gap and medium. For unconventional machining process, these are the machining methods, and these are the in the top of all are machining process, machining. And the bottom side, it mentioned parameters. For example, ultrasonic machining, current, voltage, potential, maximum 220. Same abrasive jet machine also same 220. And electrochemical machining, 10 voltage. So chemical machining we no need. And electro discharge machining, 45 volt. Electron beam machining, 150,000. That for laser beam machining 4500, plasma arc machining 100, same current, so 12 amps, 1.0 amps, 10,000 DC current, but here AC current. Then power, 2400 watts, 220 watts, 1 lakh, for EDM 2700 watts. So these are all parameters. For medium means what type of things we used for removing the metal. That means abrasive in water, abrasive in gas, electrolyte. For this electrolyte, we can prepare some chemicals or water plus salt for this electrochemical machining, and liquid chemicals, liquid dielectric, vacuum, air, argon or hydrogen. So these are the particles we used for each and every machining process. So gap, for ultrasonic machining we use 0.25 only gap, abrasive jet machine 0.75, and ECM 0.20 gap. So remaining all also 0.025, 100, 150 and 7.5 mm. So this gap we need to maintain. Next, for shape and size, application also shown in shape and size. For example, in the previous slide, so the range, higher range and lower range. So for example, work material, here we need to difficult to machine material. Here we have using tungsten carbide and electrically conductive materials. ECM we use all type of materials. Then shape to be machined. For example, if we producing micro holes, we can choose laser beam machining is best. If we producing small holes in unconventional machining process, electron beam machining is well suited. And if we using deep holes, small, big or deep holes, electrochemical machining is best process. Shallow holes means ultrasonic machining and electro discharge machining is best. Here we mentioned diameter. Based on this diameter, better, more than length is 20 mm means ultrasonic machining, UCM is good. Below length means poor. So this holes, then honing, electrochemical machining is well suited. For grinding, so these are all operations, that means threading, deburring, grinding, etching, honing, shallow holes, deep holes, these are all process. These are all process. Which machine is suitable for that? So only I am explaining. For deburring is UCM and abrasive jet machining. That UCM means ultrasonic machining and abrasive jet machining is well suited for this machining process. For grinding process, we can choose UCM beam and abrasive jet machinings. For shallow piking means abrasive jet machining is well suited. For this case only, we can, here we mentioned there, good, fair, poor. That poor means very low, fair means medium level, and good means it is fully suitable for this process. So all the things I explained. Then process capability. So the process capability, same thing, removal of material. First one is removal of materials, tolerance, surface finish, depth, power required. So these are all output parameters. So already we discussed this parameters. These parameters are input parameters. Already it will be in the machine. So these are all input parameters. We are giving parameters. So these are all output parameters. That one is MRR problem. Most of the researchers doing their project based on this machining process. So they take input parameters and output parameters. they give some based on input parameters, they give some values and change the values and remove the metals. So the output parameters, they choose material removal rate, tolerance, surface finish, depth of the surface damages, power required for machine. So these are all output parameters. If we give the input parameters, based on that we machining and we get material removal rate. So what type of material removal rate we get, what type of tolerance for surface finish, depth, all are we can choose in output parameters. For example, for USM, material removal rate 300 mm cube plus minute, tolerance is 7.5 mu and surface clearance 0.2 to 0.5, depth of surface damage 25 mu, power 2400 watts. So based on this, all the things are output parameters. Each and every machines we calculate, this amount will be this type of amounts. Abrasive jet machines, minimum quantity, then power ratio, each and every machining there we have some material removal rate, because we remove the metal. Based on this we get some tolerance, surface clearance. If the surface clearance will be 0.5 to 1.2 means it will be clear. So the next one is process economy. If we choose ultrasonic machine, means capital cost is very low, low, and tooling cost also very low, and power consumption is also low, and the material removal rate efficiency is very very high, and the tool wear also medium. If we choose abrasive jet machine, means capital cost very low, tooling cost low. So this LR mentioned low, but that M is mentioned medium level. So the machine cost also medium level we can identify. If compare with the electrochemical machining, it is very high. So the machine cost is very 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 high, and the tool cost is also medium level. If we here we mentioned all the machines, the tool cost is very very low, but the electro discharge machining only the tool cost is very high. Remaining things are all very low. So these are the process economy. If we choosing electrochemical machining, means or electro discharge machining or electron beam machining, means so the capital cost, that means the initial cost or the machine cost, is very 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 high, medium or low. So we can check it, what type of process is very high, what type of process is very low, what type of process is low, what type of process is medium. Based on that material we can choose this processes. Limitations, these are all the limitations. Unconventional machining process are more expensive, because if we use conventional machining process, means we can machining it directly, it will be finished quickly. But here unconventional machining process, it takes more time. Based on this, it is more expensive, and the material removal rate is very slow, and this process, abrasive jet machining, chemical machining, and the plasma arc machining or electron beam machining are all not commercially for economical processes. And advantage, it increases productivity, reduces number of rejected components. So in manufacturing process there we have some additional damaged components will be there. For this case we can reduce number of rejected components, and tolerance, close tolerance is possible. Harder and difficult to machining material can be machined by this process. The machined surface do not have any residual stresses. The tool material need not be harder than workpiece. This is the main advantage. if it will be low order means no harder than workpiece is harder and the tool material is very not much harder. So only we use this unconventional machining process. So first one, mechanical energy based process. So in this method we use three machining processes. The first one is abrasive jet machining, and the second one is water jet machining, and third one is ultrasonic machining. So now we are discussing what is abrasive jet machining, detailed discussion of what is abrasive jet machining and what is water jet machining and what is ultrasonic machining. So the first one is abrasive jet machining. So abrasive jet machining, here we have a principle. The first one is high speed stream of abrasive particles will be mixed with high pressure air or gas injected through the nozzle on the workpiece to be machined. So ipa tamil la sollanumna abrasive particles, konjam particles irukku, adha enna pannuvona ஹை ப்ரெஷர் ஏரம் இருக்குது, கேஸும் இருக்குது, அது கூட இன்ஜெக்ட் பண்ணி நாசில் இன்ஜெக்ட் பண்ணிடுவோம். ஸோ இன்ஜெக்ட் பண்ணி என்ன பண்ணுவோம்னா அதை வந்து நல்லா மிக்ஸ் பண்ணிவிட்டு ஒர்க் பீஸில் நம்ம த்ரோ பண்ணிடுவோம். த்ரூ நாசில் வழியாக அதுக்கு ஒரு டேங்க் இருக்குது, அந்த டேங்கில் என்ன பண்ணுவோம், மிக்ஸ் பண்ணிடுவோம். பண்ணிவிட்டு த்ரூ நாசில் வழியாக வி ஸ்ப்ரெட்டட் இன் டு ஒர்க் பீஸ். அப்போ அது பண்ணச்சில் என்ன ஆகும்னா ஆட்டோமேட்டிக்காக அதில் வந்து மெஷினிங் கெமிக்கல் ரியாக்ஷன்ஸ் ஃபார்ம் ஆகி அதுலேருந்து நமக்கு என்ன ஆகும்னா மெஷினிங் பண்ணி அந்த மெட்டீரியலை வந்து ரிமூவ் பண்ணிடுறோம், அதில் இருக்க மெட்டீரியல்ஸை ரிமூவ் பண்ணும். ஸோ இதுதான் வந்து சிம்பிள் பிரின்சிபிள். த இம்பேக்ட் ஆஃப் பார்ட்டிகிள்ஸ் ப்ரொடியூஸ் சஃபிஷியன்ட் ஃபோர்ஸ் டு கட் ஸ்மால் ஹோல்ஸ் ஆர் ஸ்லாட்ஸ் டீபரிங் ட்ரிம்மிங் அண்ட் ரிமூவிங் ஆக்சைட்ஸ். அதில் என்னெல்லாம் இதாக இருக்கோ அந்த இது எல்லாத்தையுமே அது ரிமூவ் பண்ணி எடுக்கும். இதான் வந்து அப்ரெசிவ் ஜெட் மிஷினோட பிரின்சிபிள்ஸ். ஸோ திஸ் இஸ் த ஃபிகர், சிம்பிள் ஃபிகர், அப்ரெசிவ் ஜெட் மிஷின். ஸோ திஸ் இஸ் த ஒர்க் பீஸ். ஸோ திஸ் இஸ் த ஒர்க் பீஸ். ஸோ திஸ் இஸ் த நாசில். ஹியர் வி யூஸ் சம் ஹை வோல்டேஜ் அப்ரெசிவ் கேஸ் ஜெட்ஸ் அரவுண்ட் 150 to 300 மீட்டர் பர் செகண்ட் ஹை வெலாசிட்டி. வெலாசிட்டி இஸ் மீட்டர் பர் செகண்ட். வி புட் இன் டு த நாசில் த்ரூ நாசில். ஸோ ஹியர் வி ஹவ் சம் மெயின்டைன் சம் கேப் அரவுண்ட் 0.5 to 15 mm. Push, inject through nozzle. So at the same time we get the machine. So this is the principle. So this is the basic schematic diagram of abrasive jet machining. Abrasive jet machining. Here we have gas supply tank, filters, powder supply and mixers, vibrators, pressure regulators, float control valve, hand holder, nozzle, hood, exhaust and workpiece. These are the basic things. Generally nitrogen, carbon dioxide or compressed air we used for this process. For here we use nitrogen, carbon dioxide or compressed air in this tank, gas supply tank. Generally we use the various abrasive particles used aluminium oxide, silicon carbide, glass powder, dolomite and specially prepared sodium bicarbonate. So these are the particles we used. Aluminium oxide is generally general purpose for abrasive and it is used in the size of 10, 25 and 50 microns. ஸோ நம்ம எடுக்கிற அந்த அப்ரெசிவ் பார்ட்டிக்கலோட சைஸ் வந்து 10, 25 and 50 microns. தென் வி சூஸிங் சிலிகான் கார்பைடு. வை வி ஆர் யூஸிங் சிலிகான் கார்பைடு மீன்ஸ் ஃபாஸ்டர் கட்டிங் ஆன் எக்ஸ்ட்ரீம்லி ஹார்ட் மெட்டீரியல்ஸ். ஸ்பீடாக கட் பண்ணும் எக்ஸ்ட்ரீம் ஹார்ட் மெட்டீரியலில் நமக்கு வந்து அந்த இது வந்து ஸ்பீடாக கட் பண்ணும். ஸோ ஒன்லி வி சூஸ் சிலிகான் கார்பைடு. And the third one is dolomite, 200 grit size for light cleaning and etching. We using dolomites. Then glass powder 0.302 0.6 mm for light polishing and deburring. So these are the abrasive particles using for in abrasive jet machinings. Then nozzle, here we have a nozzle and harder material tungsten carbide reduce the wear rate. Working principle, எப்படி இது வந்து ஒர்க் ஆகுது, நம்ம இப்ப சொன்னது எல்லாமே வந்து என்னன்னா என்ன கேஸ் யூஸ் பண்றோம் அது எல்லாமே நமக்கு தேவையானது மட்டும்தான் நம்ம சொல்லியிருக்கோம். இந்த மிஷினுக்கு என்ன தேவையோ அது மட்டும்தான் நம்ம இப்ப வந்து சொல்லியிருக்கோம். ஸோ எப்படி இந்த மிஷின் வந்து ஒர்க் ஆகுது, ஸோ த ஃபர்ஸ்ட் ட்ரை ஏர் ஆர் கேஸ், ட்ரை ஏர் ஆர் கேஸ் வி ஃபில் இன் த டேங்க், அதில் ட்ரை ஏயர் ஆர் கேஸ் இருக்கும். இட் வில் என்டர்டு டு தி கம்ப்ரஸர் த்ரூ ஃபில்டர், த்ரூ ஃபில்டர் வழியா கம்ப்ரஸுக்குள்ளே என்ன ஆகுது போகுது. வேர் த ப்ரெஷர் ஆஃப் ஏர் ஆர் கேஸ் இன்க்ரீஸ்டு அண்ட் த ப்ரெஷர் வேரிஸ் 2 kg/cm² டு 8 kg/cm². Compressed air or high pressure air is supplied to the mixer chamber. Based on this way, high pressure air or compressed air go through to the mixer chamber. So in the mixer chamber kullaadi nam enna pannidom, send pannidom through pipeline. The pipeline carries a pressure gauge and regulator to control the air and the fine abrasive particles are collected in the hopper of the fed into the mixing chamber. So hopper valiya enna panniruona abrasive particles nama collect panni vechiruka abrasive particles we put in the mixing chamber. The mixer of pressurized air and abrasive particles from the mixing chamber flows into the nozzle and considerable speed. So mix பண்றதுக்கு we use vibrator also. Air and abrasive particles will be imported in this mixing chamber. So we use vibrator to mix all the particles. Now inside we have some abrasive particles. The mixer of pressurized air and abrasive particles from the mixing chamber flows into to the nozzle at considerable speed. Nozzle is used to increase the speed. Why we are used this nozzle means nozzle is used to increase the speed of the abrasive particles into up to 300 m/s. ஸோ என்ன வெலாசிட்டியில் இதுலேருந்து நம்ம ஹை ப்ரெஷராக வரதை வந்து இந்த நாசில் வந்து என்ன ஆகும்னா ஹை ப்ரெஷர் அரவுண்ட் 300 m/s என்ன ஆகும்னா ஒர்க் பீஸ்லோடி ஃபுல் பண்ணும். த ஹை ஸ்பீடு ஸ்ட்ரீம் ஆஃப் அப்ரெசிவ் பார்ட்டிகல்ஸ் ஃப்ரம் த நாசில் இம்பேக்ட் டு தி ஒர்க் பீஸ். ஸோ அந்த ஒர்க் பீஸில் பட்டவுடனே ஆட்டோமேட்டிக்காக இதில் வந்து என்ன ஆயிரும் மிஷினிங் ஆக தொடங்கும். இப்போ பார்த்தீங்கன்னா தேர் இஸ் நோ டைரக்ட் கான்டாக்ட் பிட்வீன் டூல் அண்ட் ஒர்க் பீஸ், டூல் அண்ட் ஒர்க் பீஸ் due to repeated impacts small chips of material get loosened and fresh surface is exposed. So இப்போ பார்த்தீங்கன்னா நாசல் வழியாக பார்ட்டிகிள்ஸ் அடிக்கிறோம் கண்டினியூஸாக அடிச்சிட்டு இருக்கிறதுல ஆட்டோமேட்டிக்கலி ஹியர் த மிஷினிங் வில் பி டன் ஹியர் ஆட்டோமேட்டிக்கலி த மிஷினிங் வில் பி டன் ஹியர் இன் த ஒர்க் பீஸ் இன் விச் ஏரியா வி நீட் தட் ஏரியா வில் பி மிஷின். The vibrator is fixed at the bottom of the mixing chamber. So I already tell what is the use of vibrator in this area. Vibration, amplitude of the vibration control the flow of abrasive particles. In abrasive jet machine, the process differs from slant blasting process. So this is the working principles of abrasive jet machining. This is the working principle of abrasive jet machining. Here we have some material removal rate also. Material removal rate. So abrasive jet machining. What material? Hard or brittle? Glass, quartz, ceramics, mica, etc. Abrasive particles. Abrasive particles. Aluminium oxide, silicon carbide, glass powder, dolomite. Size around 25 microgram. Flow rate 2 to 20 gram per minute. Medium, nitrogen, carbon dioxide or air. Velocity 150 to 300. Pressure 2 to 8 kg per centimeter square. Nozzle material, tungsten carbide or synthetic sapphire. The nozzle tip clearance is 0.25 to 115 mm. Tolerance is 0.05 mm, and the machining operations are drilling, cutting, deburring and cleaning. So this is the process parameters. What are the parameters we used for abrasive jet machining? So the first one is mass flow rate, and the second one is abrasive grain size, and the third one is gas pressure, and the fourth one is velocity abrasive particles, and the fifth one is mixing ratio, and the sixth one is nozzle tip clearance. These are the process parameters in abrasive jet machining. These are the process parameters in abrasive jet machining. So the mixing ratio. Mixing ratio is mass flow rate of abrasive divided by mass flow rate of gas. And the gas pressure, stand-on distance, and the advantage of abrasive jet machining. Suitable for cutting all materials. There is no direct contact between tool and the workpiece. Very thin and brittle material can be cut without any risk of bearing. Thermal damage is avoided. No initial investment and good surface finishing. So these are the advantage of abrasive jet machining and the disadvantage of abrasive jet machining. Material removal rate is slow. Soft material can be machined. Machining accuracy is poor, and abrasive powders cannot be reused. So this is the one of the drawbacks in abrasive jet machining. Required some kind of dust collection system. This also one of the main disadvantage of abrasive jet machining. And application: machining of hard and brittle material, fine drilling and microwaving, machining of semiconductors, cleaning and polishing of plastic, nylon and Teflon component, surface etching and surface preparation. These are the applications in abrasive jet machining.